Iran's foreign ministry issues a harsh rebuke on the occasion Palestinians refer to as Nakba, the Day of Catastrophe.
On Nakba Day, an illegitimate entity called the Zionist Regime of Israel, supported by the United States, came into being by occupying the Palestinian land and continued to exist with war, crime, and occupation, and has turned into the main source of all regional crises and a real threat to international peace and security.
For Palestinians, May 15th is a somber day. It marks the day Israel came into being. In 1948, some 700,000 Palestinians fled their homes or were expelled. Now their descendants reside in Jordan, Lebanon, Syria, the West Bank, and the Gaza Strip. Many of them are still stuck in refugee camps, but the memories of what once was linger.
I was walking away from the sea, and a family called Yarbu from Jaffa have pointed towards a house and told me that this is my old house. When I got near the house, something made me stop walking. I started to tear up and couldn't hold myself together. I was old then, so I just walked back.
For many Arabs living inside Israel, Independence Day is also not a cause for celebration. They mark the day with speeches, rallies, art exhibitions, and protests.
I don't feel I am an Arab Israeli at all. Israel doesn't identify with the Arabs who live here, so I don't identify with it. The formula is very simple. It's a mutual feeling. I don't feel I am part of them, and they don't feel the Arabs are part of them.
And Arab states are also showing solidarity with the Palestinian cause as demonstrators took to the streets in Jordan.
Our leaders in Jordan are under heavy pressure from the Arab countries and the world, but the public will eventually prevail.
And Palestinian factions in the Gaza Strip are calling for mass protests along the fence. They have been holding a march of return every Friday for over a year. These protests often turn violent, and Israeli security remains on high alert, as Nakba Day could trigger more than just mournful emotion. Emily Rose, I-24 News.